guys, make sure you don't forget to put on a belt. If your pants are even slightly too large, you'll expose your underwear, which most people don't actually want to see. Try not to overdo it either. Suspenders don't look good when paired with a belt. This guy is so handsome. Hey, he's coming up to you. Your heart's beating rapidly. He takes your breath away. Ugh. Apparently, you can't actually breathe when he's next to you. And it's not because of his breathtaking beauty, but his breathtaking perfume. Okay, this one's not about clothing, but too much perfume is a total turnoff. Wear the right amount on the right spots. Apply it to pulse points, wrists, neck, and chest. Pointy-toe shoes, unfortunately, won't make you look elegant. They'll make your feet look gigantic and probably a bit clownish, especially if matched with sweatpants. There are many shoe mistakes that many men should avoid, like no sandals and socks together, and no square-toed shoes either. Velcro shoes may seem really comfy, but don't wear them if you're trying to look classy. If your favorite pair of shoes are flip-flops, well, let's face it, the only suitable place for flip-flops is a beach or your yard. Suits are possibly the best outfit for any man. Always leave the last button on the jacket open, and you should always unbutton your jacket while sitting. Shirts are the opposite. They should always be buttoned to the top. Never match a sports watch with an elegant suit. Even if you love this watch because your grandma gave it to you for Christmas and you haven't taken it off since. The main thing about the suit is the fit. Make sure the jacket literally embraces your shoulders. Otherwise, you risk looking like you're wearing a potato sack. You should know how to pair your suit with warm clothes. You'll want to look smart in winter, too. If it's cold outside and you need a coat, keep in mind that the whole ensemble looks better if the jacket and coat have similar lengths. If not, make sure you close the coat so no one can see the length difference. As for a tie, which often goes hand in hand with a formal shirt and jacket, there's a rule about its length too. Don't make it too short. The tip of the tie should cover the belt buckle. Match the tie clip cover with the color of the cuffs, buttons, and belt buckle. Play it safe. Opt for neutral colors such as gray or silver. As for the tie color, it should match the color of your suit and shirt, but provide at least one color accent to pop. A bow tie seems a bit more challenging to match with the rest of your clothes, but let's be honest, you can wear it whenever you want as long as it fits your overall style. Still, there's a rule when bow ties are an absolute must. If you have to wear a tuxedo, a bow tie is required. Never combine a tuxedo with a regular tie. To upgrade your look to a brand new level, try to add a blazer to your wardrobe. It can be unstructured and relaxed, creating a casual look, but looking way smarter than an old cardigan. Try owning two blazers for different seasons. A lightweight one should be made of linen or cotton and is ideal for summer. A second should be heavier, with some wool to warm you in the winter. A blazer can be paired with trousers, jeans, chinos, and even shorts, as long as they're not workout shorts. Jeans seem to be one of the few clothing items that are suitable for almost any occasion. But it can be easy to choose the wrong pair and spoil your look. The best pair of jeans you can invest in should be slightly wider in the thigh, but narrower in the ankles. This fit works great with elegant shoes and good old trainers. As for the color, it's a bit wiser to choose darker shades, since they're suitable all year round. Ripped jeans have been in fashion, and they're probably here to stay, but they shouldn't be the only ones you have. Just make sure you have a good pair of jeans that match any item from your wardrobe, and then feel free to get yourself a ripped pair. A fun t-shirt with bright prints is great for parties and informal meetings, but try not to wear them to the office, even if you don't have a dress code. Yeah, the pattern is probably interesting, and maybe the "My mom thinks I'm handsome" inscription is hilarious. Still, your colleagues, and especially your super serious boss, may draw the wrong conclusions about you. Now, don't forget to match your socks with your shoes. Black shoes and white socks are a total no. The darker the footwear, the darker the socks should be. If you don't own any black socks, head to the closest department store and get some. You look better wearing a baseball cap only if it's been 5 days since you last washed your hair. Otherwise, this accessory is sure to make you look like a college freshman. If you're totally into hats, try wearing something different. Depending on your style, a flat cap or even a fedora could be a great option. A shark tooth necklace won't make you look cool in 2020. It could work for a 90s-inspired party, but there's no way it'll match the rest of your outfit today. Jewelry is fun and can be a perfect final touch, but just make sure to keep it simple. Long hair looks good on both women and men, but there's one important rule. It should be friendly, glossy, and healthy. Don't hesitate to cut it off if you have split ends. It's just hair after all, and it will grow back. If you've got a long, greasy, and possibly receding ponytail, it's high time you headed to a barber shop to get an excellent crew cut. Oh, it's sunny outside. Sometimes wearing sunglasses is inevitable, but don't forget to store them correctly. When you no longer need them, don't keep them on the top of your head. It's acceptable to put them in your breast pocket, but ideally, you need to have a case for them to prevent scratching the lenses. You don't want to wear clothes that are two sizes smaller than you are. Clothing that's too tight means the collar on your button-up shirt almost chokes you, while the lower button tears off, revealing your belly. If the shirt is a good fit, but the collar is too tight, it's okay to unbutton a button or two, but don't go too far. A half-open shirt, especially if you're exposing your chest hair, is not a great look. What's inside your pockets matters too. Suppose you have your pockets stuffed with coins, papers, old receipts, keys, and maybe a bagel you grab for breakfast, but apparently haven't finished. Well, in that case, it's definitely gonna spoil your look. Try to find a bag that would fit in all the things you need every day. Just one tip, try not to opt for backpacks, unless you're a college student who probably needs many books and papers. A good overall look is usually made up of small details. So ungroomed hair and nails will instantly show that you're no fashionista. Look after your clothes. Make sure they're not wrinkled and there are no stains on them. Follow the rules on the clothes label. If it says to dry clean your item, don't try to wash it in the washing machine or it'll be ruined. Tumbling the clothes can be a pretty lousy idea too, since it can degrade the fabric. Wooden hangers are good for two reasons. They keep your clothes organized and will keep moths away. Keep your shoes in good shape too. Don't forget to wash and polish them. Polish softens the leather, making it last much longer and protects it from various destructive factors. Hey, you're looking good!